I want to give you a brief video demonstration on how to create an assignment using an external tool with the Google Docs Cloud Assignment. So you have this Google Drawing document called Character Traits. This is saved in my own drive as if I'm the teacher and I want to create an assignment so that my students can type directly, can write directly, can add shapes and things like that directly onto the Google Drawing and then submit to me as the teacher via SpeedGrader. And so you have to create a document like this, like you did in Google Drawing. It can work in Google Docs. It can work in Google Slides and Google Spreadsheets. This functionality does not work with Google Forms, okay? So I've got my share settings to anyone in the school system with the link can view. And so I'm going to create an assignment using this document that will then create a copy into the student's Google Drive account so that each student can individually write on this document and then they can submit it as an assignment. So I'm going to come over here to my course and I want to create an assignment for this module. Okay, so I'm going to come to my stop sign, my plus sign, create a new assignment. I'm going to call it Character Traits Google Drawing. Okay, I'm going to add. All right, so now it is located here. I want to make sure that it is published so that my students will be able to see it. So now I'm going to click on it, and now I need to go and I need to edit. Okay, so here is my assignment interface, and so for this particular assignment. So now, one of the cautions before you create an external tool. You'll need to, and you want a rubric to grade, to use the rubric to grade in SpeedGrader. You need to create the rubric before you link it to the Google document. Okay, so right now you see this as an option. Okay, once you connect it to a Google Drawing document or Google document or Google Slides or Google Spreadsheet, you will not have that option to add a rubric. Okay, so make sure you do that before you connect the document. Okay, so let's edit. So I'm going to edit this assignment. And I'm going to write my directions right here, okay? After reading the story, complete the following graphic organizer, okay? This so I'm going to say a copy of this Google Drawing will be placed in your Google Drive. Complete the assignment directly on the Google Drawing and then come back to this page. Come back to this assignment to hit submit. Okay? All right, so I'm going to then set it up as 100 points. I wanted to go to my assignments category. I want to display as points. So here's where I'm going to say in my submission type, I'm going to say external tool. Okay, we'll click on it, and now I'm going to find. So I'm going to click find, and I'm going to scroll all the way down here to Google Docs Cloud Assignment. Okay, again, Google Docs Cloud Assignment. And it's going to link to my Google Drive. So that's why it's important for you to have your students authenticate their drive or authorize their drive. They have to do it one time. And then so, all right, so here we go. And then I'm going to type in character traits. Okay, and let's see. Okay, so here you go. You can see this document right here, character traits. So I'm going to select it. I'm going to say submit. And then I'm going to say select, and we should be good. I will connect it to PowerTeacher Pro, and then I'm going to set a due date. Let's set a due date for the 31st. Okay. And then I'm going to say save. Oop, name too long. Okay. Just going to do character traits. That's a good lesson too. Got to make sure that your character is, I think, under 30 characters. That's just for the PowerSchool sync. Okay, if you want syncing to PowerSchool, then it doesn't matter. Okay, I'm going to say save. So it's still thinking. So now you can see. So here are the instructions. And this is the instruction from me. And then this is what the student will see. The embedded document below is a document the teacher has created for you called Cloud Assignment. You'll be able to edit the document in Canvas or in Google Documents. Once you have completed the assignment, you'll be able to submit it by using the submit button located on this page. So there's the submit. So this is really small area, right? And this is the way that it defaults to, it automatically defaults to this view, okay, when the students land on it. But in order to open in a larger view, they just simply click here. The page, the Canvas page is still here, right next to it, okay? So they come over here, they give it a minute. Now, this is a copy that has been saved to my Google Drive. So now I need to, because this is not, this is a static image that you created, your students will need to add their text box here, and they'll be able to type their name, Don Lursey, story title. Let's do another text box, story title. All right, I know this is a secondary example, so please forgive me. Great Gatsby, okay, and then I could do my character analysis. I'm gonna do another character here. I'm gonna do Jay Gatsby. And then I'm going to be, and I'm going to do it over here. I'm going to do another text box. And I'm going to say, is a man troubled by his constant want to be rich and powerful coming from a lowly and meager beginnings. Okay, now, of course, I can move this up. Students can move this up as well. I know because the character said, and so they'll give a quote here, quote from the novel, did, and then so on and so on and so on. Okay, so now I'm going to come back over here my students are going to come back over here, and then they're going to hit. You can see all of the changes that I made there, right? And so they're going to hit submit. Okay. And so now I know that as a teacher that this assignment was submitted to the gradebook that I can then now go over and grade in SpeedGrader. Now I enrolled myself as a student in my sandbox, so I'm hoping that this works. So I'm going to click SpeedGrader. I'll come over here. There's the PDF, there's the assignment, and now I can make comments. What a great job. I loved how you interpret Gatsby's character. Okay, yeah. Or I can do a video response here, and then I can do, if I want to, I can do a video. Sorry, it's real dark, but maybe I don't want to do a video response. Maybe I turn off my video because you can see there's a light shining back there. I can start my recording. That recording can then go to my feedback for my, so I'm going to hit submit. Okay. And then you can see here, I can also download the PDF, but I can also annotate and so forth on here. So I hope that helps you to see how you can create a Google Docs Cloud assignment in Canvas.